We're going to compare all three of the cameras on the iPhone 11 Pro and the Samsung Galaxy S10. What's going on, everyone? It is Andrew here from AppleInsider, and I have my iPhone 11 Pro and a Samsung Galaxy S10. In fact, this is the iPhone 11 Pro Max and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, though the specs are going to qualify for the S10 and the regular size iPhone 11 Pro. Now, the Samsung Galaxy S10 has three cameras just like the iPhone, an ultra-wide, wide, and tele lens, though the ultra-wide is 16 megapixels and the iPhone's is only 12. We'll show you how that impacts things in a moment. Starting out, let's look at portrait mode, or as Samsung calls it on its devices, live focus. Works at both 1x and 2x, just like it does on the new iPhone, and looking at a quick sample photo, they both look great. Though, the Samsung Galaxy S10 nailed the white balance on the blanket and the pillow, but the iPhone nailed the white balance on the cat itself. He looks far too orange and warm over on the Samsung side and looks more natural on the iPhones, so you really kind of get a mix between the two. Samsung does earn bonus points, however, for additional effects such as this kind of zoom effect. Moving on, each of these phones, as we mentioned, has three different cameras there. There's the wide angle, ultra wide, and the 2x tele lens. Everything is pretty similar, though we did mention that the Samsung has a higher resolution ultra wide lens. Let's look at some sample photos, starting with a close-up shot. Here you can see the iPhone did a little bit better. The top itself was a little more crisp and the balance was a bit better. In this shot, we start off with the wide angle lens before scoping back to the ultra wide lens. They both look really solid, though the grass is a little greener with the Galaxy S10, but the windows look a little washed out. Looking at Brazen Head, the Irish pub, we have a little bit more warmth on the Samsung side of things. The contrast is improved on the iPhone. As we get in closer, we're going to zoom this wide angle shot all the way into 200%, and you can see there's a little bit more blur on the Samsung side of things, and there's a little bit more contrast on the iPhone. For the next shot, we zoomed into 10x digital zoom on both devices. I think I prefer the Samsung side of things. There's a little bit deeper blacks there, but as we get this shot in, you can see there's a little bit more noise in the windows on the Samsung, but there's more noise on the wood on the iPhone, but the iPhone is overall better exposed. Now let's look at the image quality of the ultra wide lens specifically. Both of these shots look outstanding, but again, the S10 has that higher resolution ultra wide angle lens, and you see the difference when you crop in. Here at 300%, there is much more detail on the Samsung Galaxy S10 than there is over on the iPhone 11 Pro. Thing is, if you're cropping in that much, you might as well use the wide or the tele lens and not bother cropping it in. In other words, it's probably not gonna matter all that much. Here's another nice shot, though you can see the Samsung again has the edge, the grass is a little bit greener, the brick is a little bit warmer, again with this shot, just a little bit warmer on the Samsung side of things. In this patio shot, the iPhone again gets the edge, it has a little bit more contrast and it's a little bit sharper than it is on the Samsung. The biggest difference we saw between these two phones was night mode. Not to make a pun, but it was night and day between the two devices. We saw a huge difference as we started shooting, even just after a few photos. There was a huge difference in quality between the iPhone's night image shots and the Samsung Galaxy S10's. Let's take a closer look at those sample images. Starting off with this water fountain, there's not a huge difference between the two shots, though I do think the iPhone does look better. It quickly becomes a one-sided comparison, however, as the Samsung Galaxy often is washed out, not vivid enough, or simply blurry. Some shots like this look pretty decent, but others, it's simply not a comparison whatsoever. They're dark or they're blown out, they just don't look the same as they do on the iPhone. The S10 was also far slower. Even just saving the photos, it took a lot more time than it did over on the iPhone and made a huge impact when we were trying to take several different shots back to back. To really put these two to the test, in our last shot, we shot some flowers in complete blackness. And the iPhone actually gave us an image, albeit very blurry and grainy, but it actually showed us what we were looking at. So what's the main takeaway here? If you're shooting in well-lit stuff, it doesn't matter between the two phones. They both look great, and any of the small inconsistencies can be fixed with a couple seconds of photo editing. But if you really want to shoot in some low light or night situations, then the iPhone is the better camera by far. Send me your own shots over on Twitter at Andrew_OSU.
Hey everyone, did you guys like that video? Be sure to click on that like button so we can create content that we know that you guys want to see. And follow Apple Insider on all social media channels. If you want the best prices on any Apple gear, check out the Apple Insider price guide that is updated daily. And until next time, we'll see you later.